Yes, Peter, we are doing the chapter enemy, fine. So after many days, we're going to restart. So let me give the brief overview, fine. And then we'll continue. Not able to speak like that, that's it. So our characters are Dr. Sadao, Japanese doctor, fine. Who's very proficient enough. And he has completed his studies from America only. And now Japan is with war with America only. Clear? So this is the satirical condition. Very ironical that Dr. Sadao completed his studies from America. But now, he is very proficient doctor after completing studies from America and after meeting Hana there, and both got married and they are settled in Japan now. Fine, then the general of Japanese army, then Yumi is there, or Yumi is there, she's the housemaid. And then Tom is American prisoner of war, fine. So background, you already know World War II is there. And theme is choice between duty for nation versus duty as a doctor. Now that he has already chosen the duty as a doctor, as you know, we have read so far. That he preferred that being a doctor, I should save the life of a person, whether he is an American or a Japanese person, clear? So he decides, yeah, I will be helping this prisoner, fine, American person. His name is Tom. And now when he decided to do the surgery upon the person because he was badly wounded, clear? And then he also asked his wife for help. And when she was about to help her husband and she started puking and she had that, you know, feeling of disgust by seeing the wounded man lying on the bed. And then she ran outside and she started puking. And after puking also, she came back. That shows the true spirit of, you can say, people who are into medical profession. So again, she asked her husband that where is the anesthetic? So she has never given anesthesia to anyone, but for the first time, she's going to give this, fine. So we are on page number 34. We'll be reading from the door opened and there was Hana again. Fine, 7th-8th line is there. So let me share the screen for you all. Peter, my voice is audible to you all. Page number 34. So this is the page we are going to start from here. Yes. The door opened and there was Hana again. Where is the anesthetic? She asked in a clear voice. Sadao motioned with his chin. It is as well that you came back. This fellow is beginning to stir. Stir means to move. So he was happy that Hana has come back. He thought that she's not feeling well and she won't be returning even. But actually she came back to help her husband. Single-handedly, he was going to operate. So he was tying that battery on his head and operating because huge light was required. And then when she asked about the anesthetic, he told her that he has started already moving. So it's good that you have come. She had the bottle and some cotton in her hand, but how shall I do it? She asked. Simply saturate the cotton and hold it near his nostrils. So this was the way when the person will be sniffing it, the person gets it, the medicine goes inside and the person will be unconscious for an hour or two. So Dao replied without delaying for one moment, the intricate detail of his work. When he breathes badly, move it away a little. So Dr. Sadao is giving instructions to his wife, Hana, who has never ever given anesthesia to anyone. That this is the way to give anesthesia. And when he starts breathing badly, then remove the cotton from his nostrils. She crouched close to the sleeping face of the young American. It was a piteously thin face, she thought, and the lips were twisted. The man was suffering whether he knew it or not. Watching him, she wondered if the stories they heard sometimes of the sufferings of prisoners were true. They came like flickers of rumor, told by word of mouth and always contradicted. She's thinking that she has only heard about these stories that prisoner bhaga and he was caught and then he was captured and maybe he was treated or not. So this is the true story which she had heard earlier. Now she's seeing in front of her. In the newspapers, the reports were always that wherever the Japanese armies went, the people received them gladly, with cries of joy and their liberation. But sometimes she remembered such men as General Takima, who at home beat his wife cruelly. But now another theme is going to be started here. The theme is something else. The main theme is like duty between profession and nation only. Fine, and whether to help an enemy in dire condition or not. Recent example you can take. What happened recently? What's going on in the news? Afghanistan, Taliban, you know that? So you know the invasion of Talibanis into Afghanistan and how people, you know, they on the airport yesterday, I was seeing the news as if lines are there, people are running as if it is a railway station, as if they're going to board the train. It is earlier, it was not allowed even to reach, you can say, an airport in that way. People were running like anything madly that let us go inside, and two of the people, they were hanging with the wings only and they died. So it's not a joke for us. The people are losing their lives because they know that if they will be there again, they will be like under them only, Talibanis. So it is very, you know, pathetic condition. Half of the members are there in some other country. Half of them are there. Every person has different circumstance. And suddenly out of the blue that happened. Fine. So though the one who experiences the war and the one who have received the aftermath of war, when even the war is over, what is left is, which is beyond repairable. It cannot be repaired. We cannot express in words even. Fine. So it is, they are going to now talk about General Takima. You know, another character is there. You can see on the board, I have written General, who was not well and for whom Dr. Sadao was not sent on any duty because he was very proficient. Kya karte hain ye politicians and people on higher rank? They keep the best for themselves. Fine. And rest of the others are deputed on special duties. So what happened? Now Hannah is thinking, she remembered such men as General Takima, who at home beat his wife cruelly, though no one mentioned it now that he had fought so victorious a battle in Manchuria. If a man like that could be so cruel to a woman in his power, would he not be cruel to one like this? For instance, what is the meaning of this? The meaning is that she knows that General Takima is not a good husband at all. He beats his wife cruelly. She is saying the person who can beat his wife to such an extent, what will he do when he gets such cases that American prisoner of war? What will he do? Agar family members ke saath ye kar sakta hai, toh what about the enemy? So this is, and two things. One thing, she is making comparison. Ki agar person aisa kar sakta hai, toh then what will he do? Second thing is, we are going to another theme, that the people in power at prestigious posts doesn't mean that they're very good family members also. They're very good family heads or human beings. Your prestigious post and the way you are in real life, fine, it's not always same. You know, we start praising the people that, wow, this person has reached to such a designation. Kitna achha hoga, kitna intelligent hoga. Being intelligent and being reaching on such prestigious posts has nothing to do with your values. Fine. So as a human being also, you should be good enough. Only then your profession is going to give you something. Fine. Good morning, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, definitely. Let me stop sharing the screen because I have shared the screen. Yes, children, are you, is it audible to you all? Everybody's muted. Yes, I can unmute. No, I can unmute two, three. Yes, children, are you able to listen? Ma'am is going to talk to you now. Just send any feedback. I'm going to unmute Sukhmanjot. Okay. I'm going to unmute Gaurav. Mehak Vasan. Beta, unmute yourself. When ma'am will be talking to you, Dipin also. Amarpreet.
Good morning, ma'am.
They are wishing you, ma'am.
My voice. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, offline too.
Yes, Peter. Today I'm here to tell you about the changes in the assessment. Do you know? Last year, you know that the CBSE could not hold the exams, and afterwards, then different criteria that was made on the basis of that, the result is declared. Am I audible, Beta? Online students? Online students, am I audible?
Yes, sir. You can speak also, okay. Those who are unmuted.
Okay, anyhow, it's okay. Yeah. So criteria was formulated, and on the basis of that, the result is declared. But now this year, the CBSE is concerned about in advance that, and they have given you the planning. Okay, so what's the planning? That 2 times the term exam will be there. One that is in the month of November, December. Okay. And the second in the month of March, April. And half of the syllabus will be covered in term one, and the half that will be in term two, okay? And term one, that will be totally objective. 1.5 hour duration, and 1.5 hour duration, and 90 marks in the total marks will be, 90 minutes will be there, and totally MCQ based, right? And those MCQs will not be a very simple type of that. We'll discuss later on. Okay. And the second term, that will be of 2 hours duration. Okay. And here the open-ended question, subjective question, lengthy question, short questions will be there. Okay. Right. So this is about that, the terms. And apart from that, the term exams, there are 3 periodic tests too. Okay. One, you appeared in the month of May. Na? Now, next month, in the September also, you're going to appear. That is also your periodic test, okay? Take care of that. So you have to appear with full preparation, right? And then third one, we hope so that we'll conduct it in the month of January end or February start. Not January end, February starting, I hope so, okay? So 3 periodic test and the 2 terms, right? And also term one, term two, that will be added up for the final result. And not only that, the theory portion, the practical internal assessment, that is also to be evaluated. It's also a part of that result, okay? You know that practicals, in some of the subject, 20 marks, 30 marks, I think in your case, only 20 marks practicals are there. And the ASL in English, ASL, that's of 20 marks now, 20 marks, that is also there, okay? So half of is to be for both the term. Half part is to be covered in term one, half part is to be covered in the term two, okay? So it means if 20 marks are there, 10 marks will be evaluated in term one, 10 will be evaluated in term two, clear? So be particular about that, right? Followed with a... So in the month of November, December, the exam will be there. In the month of March and April, the exam will be there. And that question paper will be from board side. And the exam will be offline. Now, again, you have to appear offline. Next month, you are going to appear offline. Okay? And the external observer will come in the term exams, and also the CBSE person, they may also visit, okay? So it's not only holy solely, it's depending upon the school, but the externals will also be a part of that to see that whole of the process, how it's going on in the class. Okay? Right, Peter? So you have to be very, very particular, clear about that. And accordingly, you have to prepare yourself. And you should not have any doubt in your mind that the exam will be offline, may not be able to conduct. No, we will be, or CBSE will be conducting the offline exams. Okay. Otherwise, 50-50 weightage is there. In case, worst situations, in the worst scenario, if that happens, so that one of the exam, the term exam, are to be conducted offline, then the weightage will not be 50%. It means CBSE is going to prefer only offline exams. Okay. So be fully prepared for the offline exam. Right? Followed? So in practicals as well as the theory portion, concern about that. And you should be concerned about that. And also, don't think that the term one will be only MCQs. Now in the September month also, the MCQs paper is there. And this is very easy. And you can do the guesswork, or you can have an help from the others too. But that will be very bad. If you will be getting help from others, right? And it means if someone is wrong, then you will otherwise just copying blindly others. So you will not be in benefit, you will be the loser, right? Because MCQs will not be easier ones. There will be different category of the MCQ. Only a few of, four or five of you, you may be getting a simple type of the MCQs, okay? Simple type, knowledge-based MCQs. And there'll be a category where you have the two right answers in that. So combination of that, the option may be that one option answer, right answer is one and the fourth part, or one and the third part, like that. So if you know the reasoning, if you know the logic behind that, only then you will be able to answer that, okay? The third category, again, that will be very logic based, and that will be assertion and reasoning type of that, okay? If you know the reason behind that, why that part is, why that option is the right answer, then only then you will be able to get, you will be able to solve, and you will be credited for that. Okay, so guesswork will not be there, right? Followed? So there may be other type of question like matching type of that. So matching type of that will also not be very easy one. You used to do so in the lower classes, very simple one, okay? But not here, simple one. And maybe sequencing type of that. Number of statements are there. You have to put in right sequence, right? Like in accounts or in economics, you may have the question, here the length of the question, that will be short, but to find out the answer, that will require time for that. So like numerical problems are there. So you may have to solve those. Don't keep in your mind that so these cannot be asked in the MCQs. They can be asked in the MCQs. Your ma'am might have told you that in which way they can be asked. Is it? Have you told? Have she told? Right, good. So I hope that mentally you are prepared now. Any doubt? No? Online students, beta, any doubt? Say yes or no, those who are unmuted. Don't show me thumbs up only. Yes, yes, you can speak, beta. Yeah, come on. Any doubt? Who's unmute? Dekho, I'm happy. Who is unmute?
Yes, Amarpreet, you can speak with her.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Sukhmanjot, you also tell your feedback to ma'am.
Again?
No, ma'am.
Well, they mute themselves, no?
Okay, okay, okay. They have the option to mute themselves. Okay. So I hope that you are doing well at home. Why not to join your friends in the school? Yes?
Many of them will come, like,
so be regular attending the classes and prepare well for the exams. Okay. Hope all the best to you. Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Keep in mind the guidelines given by ma'am. fine beta, this is exactly what CBSE has given. And apart from it, one project is also there in English. Fine, I hope you know about that. I have already sent in group. Clear? Okay, let's continue, beta. You're not supposed to sleep. If you're not feeling well, you can take the leave, fine, but don't sleep in the class. So, beta, yes, you were at last just now. Okay, distance maintain. So, we were reading. She was thinking that people like General Takima, who brutally beats his wife, but when it comes to how he will handle these enemies, okay. Now, Gaurav, no need to send any, ma'am has already gone. So let's continue. Gaurav, any questions and all regarding exams, we will talk later on about this. I'll be also telling you later on. So let's continue with the chapter first, okay? Fine. So now she hoped anxiously that this young man had not been tortured. It was at this moment that she observed deep red scars on his neck just under the ear. So when she was going to give anesthesia to this boy, she noticed that there was some scar on his neck and under the ear. Those scars, she murmured, lifting her eyes to Sadao. But he did not answer. At this moment, he felt the tip of his instrument strike against something hard. Dr. Sadao was busy in finding the bullet because this was very... need of the hour to extract that bullet out of his body. Clear? So when he was about to take that bullet and she was asking some questions, he did not respond. Dangerously, it was near the kidney only. So all thought left him. He felt only the purest pleasure. He probed with his fingers, delicately familiar with every atom of this human body. His old American professor of anatomy had seen to that knowledge. Ignorance of the human body is the surgeon's cardinal sin, sirs. He had thundered at his classes year after year. So this is one example. To teacher ne padhaya hota, kabhi na kabhi aapko yaad rehte. You keep on remember, and it is not from the books. It is out of the books always. Fine, books wali cheeze to aap, you are just reading for the sake of getting marks. But sometimes some moral lessons, some preachings you remember throughout. Even you will remember what my teacher said in class nursery to me. Sometimes you remember, okay, this teacher treated like this in a good or bad, both ways. Fine, you remember for many years. So now while doing operation upon this American prisoner, he remembered his anatomy professor, that who used to say that a doctor or a surgeon who does not know the human body, it is a cardinal sin. Because you should be able to, you know, even blindfolded, you should know where to touch the body and how to operate upon and all. So he's now remembering those words of his teacher. It is not quite at the kidney, my friend, Sadao murmured. So he's talking to himself now. It was his habit to murmur to the patient when he forgot himself in an operation, my friend. He always called his patients. So now he did, forgetting that this was his enemy. See, so this is the habit, na? Jaise hum kehte hain, beta, children, my dear students, this is our habit. Similarly, doctors do have their own pet words. He used to address his patients as my friend. Fine, that was his habit, that my friend, I'm going to operate upon you, my friend, in that way. So when he started saying my friend to American prisoner Tom, then suddenly he realized that it is his enemy only and he's calling him my friend. Then quickly, with the cleanest and most precise of incisions, the bullet was out. The man quivered, but he was still unconscious. Nevertheless, he muttered a few English words. So American American prisoner, he started, you know, murmuring in unconscious state only. Guts, he muttered, choking. They got my guts. Sadao, Hana cried sharply. Hush, Sadao said. So he was not letting Hana speak because he was so much involved into getting that bullet out. The man sank again into silence, so profound, so deep, that Sadao took up his wrist, hating the touch of it. Yes, there was still a pulse, so faint, so feeble, but enough if he wanted the man to live, to give hope. So he just checked the, you can say, wrist of that boy, and still he could feel that he's alive. So feeble pulse was moving on. But certainly I do not want this man to live, he thought. Again, mind is saying that I don't want this man to be lived. And why he's saving that man then? Fine, that it means he has a good heart. But certainly, then no more anesthetic, he told Hana. So he says, now my part is done. I have extracted the bullet. Now stop giving anesthesia to this boy. He turned as swiftly means as fast, as though he had never paused. And from his medicines, he chose a small vial and from it filled a hypodermic and thrust it into the patient's left arm. So he injected one medicine into his body and he was working madly upon him. Then putting down the needle, he took the man's wrist again. The pulse under his fingers fluttered once or twice and then grew stronger. So after getting injected, his pulse started getting normalized. It was very weak, very feeble. This man will live in spite of all, he said to Hana and sighed. So finally he declared that this man is going to survive. The young man woke so weak, his blue eyes so terrified when he perceived where he was. Now the impact of anesthesia has gone away. The man is coming back to his senses. He has blue colored eyes when he opened it. He was terrified when he saw where he was. That Hana felt compelled to apologize. She herself served him, for none of the servants would enter the room. See, though this is an enemy for them and servants refused to help them, so Hana was there to feed that enemy also. When she came in the first time, she saw him summon his small strength to be prepared for some fearful thing. Don't be afraid, she begged him softly. She saw that this boy was very afraid and terrified. So she started giving, you can say, a hope to him. She started making him comfortable. And then she said, don't need to get afraid. And how come you speak English? He gasped. So he was quite shocked that Japanese lady, and she's talking to me in English. And you remember that both Hana and Sadao for long 8 years, they were in America only, completing their study. So that's why they have learned the language of America, that is English. I was in long time in America, she replied. She saw that he wanted to reply to that, but he could not. And so she knelt and fed him gently from the porcelain spoon. He ate unwillingly, but still he ate. So she started feeding that American boy. He was not having the strength enough to respond properly even. Because kitne dino se usne kuch khaya nahi hai, fine? Now you will soon be strong, she said, not liking him and yet moved to comfort him. So this is very difficult situation where you are helping your enemy. You are not supposed to help, but even then you are helping. Clear? So tomorrow we'll continue from page 36. And I guess by Wednesday only we will be able to finish if we increase the speed accordingly. Fine? Well, Wednesday, sorry for that. Then one extra class we'll arrange. No problem. Okay, beta, have a nice day.